Shaw.
Hello. Goodbye.
Hey, Nuno. Nuno.
Who's talking to me?
Hey.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
How thank you, you for yesterday.
Thought it was God speaking to me.
Yes.
Come on, DJ. Let's go.
Yes. まずですね、この N シリーズに出会うまでのいきさつをヌーノから聞きたいんですけども。
It started because I didn't have any money and I was sleeping in a rehearsal space in Boston. And so I wanted a new guitar and I went to a store and I bought a bunch of parts because I couldn't afford a guitar. So I bought like a, you know, a body, a separate neck.You know, all the pieces because it was cheaper. So then I put the body together and I couldn't afford to paint the guitar. So it just became natural wood. And that's basically how it started. As I was playing with Extreme, somebody saw me perform at a club in Boston, somebody from Washburn, and they asked me if I wanted to endorse, be, you know, one of their endorsees.So what happened is when Washburn reached out to me, they said, you want to be an endorsee? So they sent me a catalog of which guitar I wanted to play. And I told them, I don't want to play one of their guitars. I want to play mine. So they were like, what? You mean that guitar with no paint and no... I said, yeah, I want it just like it is. And they told me that it would never sell. They told me that we can't sell a guitar with no paint. And I told them, well, then I don't want to work with you. So then I didn't do it.So then they said, okay, we'll do a guitar with no paint, but it's not going to do well. So I remember going to the NAMM show in Los Angeles, and we had a little table about this big. You know, Washburn was really small. And I remember looking in the middle of the NAMM show, and Ibanez was huge. It was big, and Steve Vai, and pink guitars, and green guitars, and all stuff. And I, you know, I was like, oh, wow. And the following year, once Extreme had success, we had the big part in the middle, and other companies were making wood guitars and wood finishes and natural finish. So that's the end of the story, I think.
And then a second question.
What is the biggest difference between the N series and other guitars?
It's interesting, you know, a guitar is a personal thing. You know, it's not necessarily, I don't think I've ever played a guitar and I don't think anybody can say one is better than the other. Mm-hmm.But I think a guitar is a personal thing that you find that, you know, is yours. And it's incredible because I've had the opportunity to play some of my heroes' guitars. You know, I played Brian May's guitar, the original. I played Eddie Van Halen's guitar, you know, with them. And I always thought, wow, I can't wait to play the guitar so I can sound like them or play a thing. And unfortunately, when I picked them up, I still sounded like me. So I was very disappointed, But what I noticed is I cannot play the guitars. So as great as Brian May is, his guitar was awful to play. It was awful. I could never play like a solo or a song on it, but it's for him. So for me, you know, the N4, I never imagined it was going to be a guitar that other people were going to play. I always just, it was for me. So I've tried to, you know, I have other guitars and I've tried to, I don't play it. The good thing about it, I don't play it because I endorse it. Mm-hmm. I play it because I actually love playing it. It's my baseball glove, you know? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what I do.
Right. Sad question.
You're going to need more paper. I talk a lot.
It's okay. I think. We assume most of the professional guitar users custom guitars. And do you use the guitar N4 guitars as it is, or do you customize the guitars?
Yeah, you know, it's interesting. I've always had this crazy issue that I always knew. Well, I didn't know when I was younger, but I found out that, you know, that once you meet people that are on tour, like, you know, whether it's Eddie Van Halen or any of the Steve Vai, a lot of the times the guitars or amplifiers that they have are, they look the same. They look like this. They're called the same model, but they're customized or they're changed. And I never wanted to do that. You know, I always said that I wanted to be able to, you know, say my, you know, if I, tonight I get a phone call, or right here I get a phone call saying that all my guitars have disappeared, you know, they're stolen or whatever. I actually feel really comfortable that I could come into the store and just pull two or three off and, you know, set up the action and be able to do the show the the same way and sound like me. Now, it's not going to be like mine exactly because it takes years to feel it, but I feel comfortable enough that I always wanted to be able to pull one off the wall. So if somebody wanted to play my guitar, that's my guitar. Mm. You know what I mean? Exactly. There's no, you know, crazy stuff going on. And it's a simple guitar anyway, so it makes it easy. But yeah, it's always like mine. Yeah.
All right.
But if you try to steal my guitar, I will find you and kill you. with the new ones.
Four questions.
Do you have any particular taste for pickups?
Other than what, the one that's on my guitar?
Yes, other than what's on your guitar.
I'm actually one of the worst people in the world. You know, how do I put this? Like, technically speaking, for guitars and pickups, and like, so many guitar players, almost all the guitar players I know, people like Paul Gilbert that I know, these guys, they're so into going into stores and trying pickups and, you know, always looking for the new thing, whatever. I'm really boring, and once I find one thing that works, I pretty much go with it. So I don't really know much about any other pickups than the ones that I use. I just know they sound good. I just, you know, even when I started using the Bill Lawrence that I have, you know, I just liked the way it sounded. And Bill Lawrence had gone out of, he went out of business. So because I, you know, Washburn said, well, we can't put these on the guitar because the business doesn't exist. I said, well, put them on there anyways and tell them to open. So I kind of, I got this great letter from him saying thank you for, because all the pickups, he got to reopen, you know, his whole lineup, and, you know, I made the pickups for my guitar. So I just like what I have. I'm sure there's amazing, incredible pickups in this room somewhere, probably even better than mine. But like I said, I don't really pay too much attention to that, unfortunately. Maybe I should, you know, maybe I could sound better. I don't know.
Hi. じゃあ次 いきます. Five question.
The N4 series comes in a lot of wood bodies. Which is your best?
You know, I always, once again, I always had the same one that I've used, which is alder, but I've really been into recently just, you know, I liked when they started trying different woods, and Koa I like, and there was a Carina one that I really liked. I don't know, I think it's really, I personally think it's a beautiful thing that obviously the guitars, they're made out of wood, you know, and I think it's really cool that when you show off the wood. I know paint jobs look great and they can look really nice, but I think there's something specific there. You know, they sound a lot warmer without the finish, so I kind of prefer that a bit. But I'm the Paduke, obviously, I played for a long time. That's really interesting sounding and different as well.
How do you play the N series different from the P series? Do you sort of use them separately?
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely two really different types of guitars. You can't play them the same way. You play differently on them. You create differently on them. They're just really different guitars. But I love the sound of both of them. Yeah, it's just the shortest answer I've ever had.
What kind of effects do you use on stage?
Not a lot. I mean, predominantly, it depends what I'm doing, but mostly. I for pedals, all I have is this Boss octave pedal, and I use like a noise gate maybe, but I use a Boss multi effects because for the extreme stuff that I've used for years. It's, once again, I don't know if it's the greatest thing in the world, but it's it's the only one that I've used, so I never really changed much of it.
We want a comment for guitar players who use the N4 series.
Yeah, sure, but is this actual water?
Yes, yeah. That's water.
Yeah. There's no label, so I'm,
we took it off.
I'm a little bit scared. Yeah. I'm sorry, the question was?
A comment for players who use the N4 series.
Comments?
Comments.
I don't know, maybe they have comments for me. I don't know. I mean, other than I'm kind of, you know, whenever I see somebody with my guitar, I always feel really like, humbled. You know, I feel like, wow, they're playing one of my guitars, and it's I don't know if you can have more of like of a dedication, of an honor, you know, somebody saying, listen, I respect you and like your music enough that I actually want to play your guitar. Mm-hmm. I think that's one of the greatest compliments a person can ever have. So it obviously makes me really happy, you know.
The last tour was a reaction of the porno graffiti. How about the concept of this tour?
The tour itself?
Yes.
Oh, I mean, this is the We're Running Out of Concepts tour. you know what, we wanted to look, to be honest with you, I'm a little disappointed this time around, because this is the first time we've ever really toured without an album, without a new album, and it's very odd for us to do that. I'm not going to blame anybody as to why we don't have a new album. I'm not going to mention any names, Pat, Gary, of why we don't have a new album. I was ready. Everybody blames Rihanna, but Pat's doing a solo album. Gary's got a solo album, so we have to wait. The concept actually here is we wanted to at least come back and do, you know, since it is 25 years of an anniversary for us here, we thought we would try to put in as many songs as we can that we've never done before. Not only here, but even some songs we've never even played before. So that's the idea. Yeah, we never played a Katy Perry song before, but we did it last night. And I'm sure the fans loved it. Their faces were like... like, is this a new extreme song?
How was the first performance yesterday?
It was amazing, actually. Yeah. I don't know. Do you think so? Why are you laughing? Was it terrible? No, we had fun. You know, it's... We actually put the set list together maybe 15 minutes before we went on. So it was kind of confusing for us, because we had to keep looking at that. Normally we're very well rehearsed and we know what we're playing. But last night we kept, you know, it was like a cover band. It was like an extreme tribute band. And we were like, we're looking at it going like, oh, that's right, that's next. And how does that go? You know, and it was pretty fun. It was fun for us because it was different than what we normally do. But I thought it was great. Was there anybody here last night?
Yeah.
Was it okay? Good show?
So したらですね、石橋のスタッフのジェイソンから2つほどクエスチョンございます。ジェイソン。
Two of our customers here have come from New Zealand just to come here for the tour.
What are they? ニュージーランド。手前いる2人。
You guys idiots? Are you crazy? It's too far.
手前の2人は。
Yeah, this is true. This is true.We have a few more in the back that are from Australia as well. Just because you come all this way, you think you can ask me a question? Yeah, go ahead.
ここまで来たからって質問できると思ってるんですか?
Okay.
I really love Extreme because I hear so much of the Queen influence in you guys, the harmonies and the guitar playing stuff. Do you think you and Brian will ever do like a thing together?
Wow, you know, it's interesting. I saw a photo on Instagram yesterday, of an old photo of me and Brian. And I was thinking about how it's interesting that I've never done anything with him, or never even thought about it, you know. Or, you know, we've been around each other. We've never said, hey, let's do something. That would be really cool, you know. That would be really cool. I think it's a good idea. When you call him, ask him for me, will you?
Do you have his phone number?
As a matter of fact, I do. Thank you so much, you know, for coming. They told me when I was in the car on the way here that they didn't tell anybody I was going to be here until this morning. That is crazy to me. I don't understand. That's very Japanese. Because I was like, you know, don't you guys have to work or school or something, or, you know, never. Nobody works here. Nobody has a life. Nobody has anything. So I don't know what you did to get here today and so quick, but I didn't expect to see this many people here, so I appreciate it so much. Thank you. But don't move. All right. Before you go, though, can I take a picture of all of you? I'm going to do one just you, and then I'm going to jump in with you. Okay. All right. But I need all your hands up in the air.
There. That'll be nice. Thank you so much. Can you take one of these? I want to jump right in.
あ、じゃあ前の方ちょっと座りましょう。落ち着いてね、落ち着いてね。Thank you, Nuno. Yeah, have a good show.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Arigato.
Okay, see you, man. Right, thank you. See you, man. See you, see you, see you. See ya. Bye. See ya. Thank you for making the trip. I appreciate it. You're crazy, but thank you so much.
Thank you.
はい、どうもありがとうございました。ニューノにもう一度逆勝。
It's the dancer. It's the dancer. It's
quick to hug. Yeah, yeah, you'll remember.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
What the hell?
This is Ishibashi Music's original.
Wow.
Yeah, great.
You know,
this is Azores.
You know my original one?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's stolen. I had a storage with about 12 guitars and mm-hmm. all the amps I used on the first album, mm-hmm. second album, third album. Oh. Somebody broke in and stole all the storage.
Oh my god.
I cried a lot.
We revived this guitar.
Yeah. That's amazing.
Yeah, thank you very much.
I want to get a picture of that.
Yeah. Your guitar's butt is a little bit tiny.
Oh, that's...
Yeah.
What, the Portugal?
Yeah.
That's. I think they do like that on purpose. I didn't have that on mine.
Yeah. Oh.
I didn't have that one on mine. Mm-hmm. But that's supposed to be the way it's, the flag is. Yeah. Great.
ようになってで駅すいませんどうかエキストリームとして
普通に Do you want me to do it?
No, it's okay.
Japanese?
No, I'm fine, sorry.